Is that a newspaper you guys are asking? No, it's not newspaper. It's actually a grocery flyer. And yes, it's on my painting. And oh my gosh, you guys, I do not know if it's gonna work. I just decided to try this because I wanted a big flower on a big canvas. So yes, I'm keeping my fingers crossed. You guys have to stick around. You guys have to watch to the end, and you guys have to wait to see if it's gonna be a success or if it's a failure, guys. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Well, a friend of mine gave me a color palette that she wanted me to use to create a flower for her. So I'll be using that palette to do a reverse flower dip on a big canvas. So I actually wanted to use a paper napkin on this, but the biggest size I could find was a 16 by 16, which, believe it or not, it was not big enough. So I decided to use the flyer, all right, the grocery flyer. Right, as you guys can see, I've already laid my base color, which is a custom-made yellow mixed with gold. I'm currently laying my colors in a pattern. Hopefully, I stay in sequence because sometimes, I forget to add a color here and there, and but yes, guys, that's how it is in art. And of course, some masterpieces were created by making mistakes. So yeah, this step, I'll be repeating it three times. Okay, guys, I'll be quiet now. Thank you.
Thank you.
Alrighty guys, after adding my last circle, I then use a skewer to draw lines out and then in. I do this to hopefully create those beautiful petals that make it look somewhat like a flower. Pretty fascinating, don't you think? Another thing I wanted to point out to guys with my flyer here, you can tell that it's damped. You know, it's just so that the paint can connect with the flyer. You know, there has to be contact with the flyer and the paint. Usually I use like dry paper napkin. It's, you know, it's not a big deal with a napkin, but you know, the paper is doesn't have that soft texture. So yeah, I damped it a bit just to soften it a bit and make contact with the paint much more smoothly. And I'm gently giving it a pat. You know, I pat it softly, barely touching barely touching that that flyer. You know, I don't want to smash my paint, so I tend to normally use the back of my hand, because you know, I don't want to put too much of a pressure on the paint. And yes guys, I'm lifting it now. Oh my gosh. And you know, you have to take your time when you're lifting this part here. It's, you can't rush, just take your time. And yeah, I just go by corners, the four corners at a time. And yeah, here it is. As I take you guys in for a close-up, I want you guys to understand something here. When the paint is drying, it actually it spreads out a little bit more than from when I just lifted it with the flyer, when I just lifted the flyer. So it spreads out a bit, and then the paints, they're different. Some paints are opaque, some are transparent. So some of the paint, as you can see, the gold, it took over the yellow a bit. It's like I lost my yellows. Like, they're not showing as vibrant. That's just how it is, guys. You know, with the fluid art, sometimes you are in for surprise, all right? And you know me, guys, I hang it on my wall to display. Here it is. It's dried. It's beautiful. It's shimmering. I love, 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 love that bright pink, that neon pink. Love it. Love the bright blue. I mean, they just add a little bit of a contrast, a little bit of a, it's just so beautiful. She really chose a beautiful color palette. What do you guys think? Leave me a comment in the comment section below. Give me a thumbs up and a like. Share with your friends. Bye. See ya.